Good morning.
Hello.
Welcome.
Good morning. Thank Hello. You very much. Hello.
Thank you for playing. Thank it's you for being here from me. Italy.
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you.
You're also playing on this beautiful CD.
Yeah.
Really.
Thank you.
Was he well known to you?
No, not at
no,
all.
No. Okay.
In fact, when I met Hertian, he was the first person to mention to me about the music of Franz Kasseus. And after hearing his vinyl and a few of Marc Ribot's recordings, I was completely thrilled and interested. And it was really a matter of very lucky connections and a constellation of lucky events that Marc, in the very same period, found a manuscript of Kasseus, which was kept in a
this
vinyl.
One, huh?
Inside of Kasseus' house, and which contains more than 25 compositions, but most of them are sketches. So we decided to work a lot on this manuscript, and we found 19 new compositions, which we included in the complete music for guitar solo of Kasseus.
So this is what you found there in the apartment?
Yeah.
Okay.
Exactly.
What's so interesting about this music? As a guitarist, explain us? Or?
For me, it's extremely interesting because it's a sort of mixture. It's a special mixture between what is folkloristic in the Kasseus tradition. So there are these elements of Creole music, African rhythms. From 1915 until 1934 in Haiti, there was this American in military occupation. And this was also ambivalent. There was an ambivalent relationship by Kasseus towards this invasion because on one hand, he was fearing of losing the traditional musical heritage. But on the other hand, he was also influenced by hearing the jazz music, which was played by the military. So there is also an American aspect. Some chords remind very much of jazz in these pieces. And all this is permeated and kept into a frame which is classical, because Kasseus had a very classical education. So this combination of very different aspects makes Kasseus a unique personality in the guitar world.
Can you show us a little bit what is unique, what is his sound,
for
what
example,
is his
idea
of?
Yeah, he never wrote very technical demanding pieces, but he worked very much on the timbre and on the sound. So let's, for example, there is this piece called Rara, and the name is very interesting because it represents the carnival festival before Easter in Haiti. So he uses a folkloristic song, melody. So he uses this very folkloristic melody, permeated with jazz chords, but also with these typical African rhythms, ta, ta, pam, 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 pam. And the interesting thing is that he never wanted to represent faithfully a song. When he moved to the United States, he was a sort of homesick artist who wanted to get again in contact with his culture through evoking it.
Okay.
Yeah.
I invite you to go on stage.
Sure.
And thank you for coming.
Thank you very much.
Thank
Pleasure.
You.
Thank you.